I'm delighted to welcome on stage Aditi Tyagi, who will moderate this session. She is a specialist in sports news and a prominent news presenter at international sports events. Hi, Aditi. Welcome.
Hi. Thank you very much.
Please have a seat. I would now like to welcome on stage co-founder and director of Evolution Sport and the Badminton Gurukul, consisting of 24 training academies across 9 states in India. The reigning Indian national champion in women's doubles and mixed doubles, she is involved with several governing bodies and has organized many badminton events. Let's welcome Supriya Devgan. Our next sportswoman is the most decorated woman basketball player in India, holding the Indian record for 23 medals in national championships. She has represented India in the Commonwealth Games, the Asian Games, and is only the third woman to win the Arjuna Award. May I have a round of applause, please, for Prashanthi Singh. Hailing from village Barua in Manali, this 21-year-old made history by winning India's first ever international medal in skiing. She clinched the bronze in the coveted Alpine Eder 3200 Cup in Turkey. Ladies and gentlemen, Achal Thakur.
So we all celebrate heroes. But now is the time to celebrate, as Maya Angelou said, sheroes. Please give them a huge round of applause, because you can't even imagine what they go through. And actually, I'll start with you. And in fact, I remember talking to your International Federation, FIS, 6 months ago, trying my best to convince them about the potential in the Indian market. I remember I couldn't do that 6 months back, but now confident that their perception about the Indian market has changed. So, has life changed for you?
Yeah, of course. A strong sense of happiness overtakes you when you make your country proud. And I think, of course, this medal has become a turning point for me and for winter sports in India. And I saw pride in my parents' eyes. And if I talk about my journey, it was not easy at all. I was only 5 years old when I started skiing. And I skied with wooden skis that my brother made for me, because we couldn't afford the original skis. They were really expensive for us. And we used to climb up for hours just to ski down for a minute with those heavy skis on shoulder. And at the age of 11, I had to go to abroad far away from my parents to train. And I was a kid and I used to cry a lot. But I think all those difficulties had made me stronger and helped me to get where I'm today.
Prashanthi, you are the most decorated basketball player. You are the only third woman basketball player to get Arjuna Award. Do you think your success has been celebrated the way as men are celebrated?
Not really, because you know it took almost 25 years of hard work of entire family. Family who has all the players. Like all our brother system, we are players, we are athletes of India, we represent India. And it took 25 years of hard work to get some recognition, some appreciation to this level. So it's not the way men are celebrated. Even if you see Maya Moore, the Jackson, these girls are leading basketball players of WNBA, and you will not find their jersey in showroom. Like you will find the Kobe Bryant, you will find the other players. So it's worldwide. It's just not India, it's worldwide.
So you're talking about world, and there are only a handful of women sports administrators around the world, Supriya. And here I would like to quote some data from Women on Board. And the data is shocking, because there are only 18% women in boardrooms of 28 international federations assessed. And then 129 National Olympic Committees, the number dips to 16.6%, which is down from 2014. So how difficult it has been for you?
So I would say from being a sportswoman to an administrator to being an entrepreneur in the space of sport, I've been living this journey my entire life facing the patriarchy. I mean, it starts from practice games at home clubs where the boys want to say, I don't want to play with a girl. Game's not good enough. Is it really not good enough, or are they scared to lose to a woman? Absolutely. I mean, from competition to institutional support, gender has always come in the way. And then moving to my journey as an entrepreneur, wanted to make a difference in the space of sport, not just do some work and earn money. And that's when I decided you've got to do events with a twist. You've got to raise the perception, the profile. You need to celebrate the sport and the sports people who've achieved for the country. And that's what brought me, did a national event, changed the perception, put in our own money, and got invited to the AGM of the Federation, where got the opportunity to run international events of the country for badminton, which was the Super Series, the Thomas Cup, the PBL. Did a fantastic job, but I know how we got there. It was challenging. The decision makers were men. They always thought you got the projects because either you're good looking or because you're somebody's pet who's a decision maker. It was never about how good you are at what you do. You always have to perform extraordinarily to even exist. And there were lots of times you get demotivated, dejected, and you know, ask yourself, really, what am I doing here? But then you're a sportsman. You've never learned to lose. You're strong-willed, you know, you decide you have to be in the system to make a difference. And that's what kept me there. And people like Gopi Chand, who were dear friends, were my rock-solid support. He always said one line to me, Supriya, the story is on your side. It's never on the other side.
And as they say, sports is not just entertainment. It's a way of life. It teaches you so much about life.
Absolutely, absolutely. That's what really kept me walking, leading. So yeah, that's my journey so far.
So Achal, now I would like to talk about the media portrayal of sportswomen, sportspersons, and working for UNESCO's World Radio Day. We found some really shocking numbers. Only 7% women represent of all the sports people who are portrayed or who are read, watched, or discussed in media. Only 4% sports stories are primarily focused on women. And when women are portrayed, they are usually portrayed in their social roles, as in mother, sister, daughter. And sometimes there is a degradation of in their portrayal, they are degraded into sexual object. Did you ever come across this? I'm sure media coverage is a problem for your sport.
Yes, of course. As far as media coverage is concerned, in my game, there is nothing, not at all. Because people in India doesn't know what is skiing. Many times when I tell them I'm an alpine skier and I do skiing, and they say, oh yeah, ice skating. And that makes me so sad. There is, like, I want media coverage as much as cricket gets. There is not only summer sports, there are also winter sports. Winter Olympics are also such a thing, and alpine skiing is the major game of Winter Olympic Games. And I think contribution of media will help really to make people aware of skiing, winter sports, and also to government that what difficulties we are facing about infrastructure and also about finance.
Prashanti? Yeah. Yeah. It's a chicken and egg situation. Federation said, oh, there's no media coverage for the sport, so what's the point in showing women's sports? And the media says, oh, these sports are not shown on TV.
Yeah. So, this actually happens because, you know, just because of media educate people. Through media, people get educated what is sport, who are the sportsperson of the nation, who are getting glory. Jangal mein mor racha kisne dekha? Koi jeet ke aaya hai, kisko pata? Kaun kahan kya khela, kya pata? This is media is the medium. So when there's less media, so players are who are even getting, you know, they're getting facility, they're not getting, they're winning, they're not winning, nobody knows and no one cares. So that is a big problem with the Indian sport. Haan, bas, jaise koi bhi, jo hum log tournament khel karke aate hain, एयरपोर्ट पे कोई आया नहीं लेने के लिए, यहाँ किसको पता? This is all happens to most of the sport.
Now there is social media, so players can tweet and the world gets to know about
them. Yeah, maybe this is the reason now we are being celebrated here. Ki people know she's a skier, I'm a basketball player, and she's an entrepreneur. Otherwise, see how it was earlier. It's not that we, today we, I just won Arjun Award. I've been playing this sport since 15 years. Who knows what I'm doing?
So Priya, it's interesting that movies like Dangal or Marie Kondo, they turn out to be super hits. And I was looking at BARC numbers from 2016, and I would not get into cricket here. Archil, you were mentioning cricket. I would not even get into cricket. And there were some numbers which were really interesting. Kabaddi World Cup was watched by 44% women. Kabaddi League was watched by 44% women. When women are watching, when women are playing, so who is deciding whether or not to broadcast women's sports?
That's a very interesting stat, actually, Aditi. Not that even I had read about this, but there is a clear media bias for women-centric sports. 2 to 4% for 40 to 45% of athletes that are women, there is a clear-cut bias. But like you yourself said, it's a vicious circle. When you speak to media, they say, well, there's not enough, you know, there isn't enough TRP. Like even when we were doing the PBL, we wanted to decide what the format of the tournament should be, the first edition. And we said, can we put in a women's doubles? Can we not? Broadcast partners saying there isn't enough TRP. So the format was decided by the TRP.
But where is this TRP coming from? Because 44% women watching Kabaddi, I'm not even talking about cricket. You can imagine how much would be there.
I agree. Like I said, vicious circle. Sponsor doesn't want to put in money because there isn't enough media coverage. Media doesn't want to cover because there isn't enough money. Mm-hmm. Where does this end, you know? Somebody has to be the first. Everybody cannot be the first to be the second. You know, everybody, when you win medals, everyone wants to invest money. How about investing money to bring the medals? You know, that's where it starts. And I mean, I'm fortunate to be sitting in a forum like this where I have a voice, and I believe there are a lot of media decision makers, stakeholders sitting right here. So I think it's time to make a plea. Let's be the first. Help us.
Yeah. So Archil, now I want to talk about gender pay gap. And there is this Global Sports Salary Survey 2017. Which says that among top 100 professional players, men earn 24% more than women. Forbes' list of top 100 highest paid athletes has only one woman player, that's Serena Williams. And that too because she plays a sport which pays equal amount, equal award money for Grand Slams. Coming back to India, we saw what happened with BCCI contracts. I don't want to argue in favor or against. But the fact is, women's team didn't get to play much cricket. Their games when they were in South Africa and rewriting history books at the same time, when the men's team was doing that, most of the games were not even broadcast. So how big is this issue of pay gap? I'm sure it's very big. And how can it be addressed?
Yes. Personally, it really makes me so sad that we are living in such a progressive world, such a fast world, but our mindset is so slow. If we talk about women have been fighting from years for equal pay, for equal opportunities, for equal dignity. And we will fight till we get what we deserve. And I think also the women athletes are paid less than male athletes. And for this, we all have to come together, not as a city or a country, but as a people of whole world to support all the women and girls everywhere. That can help.
Prashanti, just to throw another stat, FIFA Women's World Cup, 3 years back, they got $15 million prize money. And you know how much is the prize money in Russia for the upcoming edition? $400 million. So the gap is so big. It's not about men and women. It's about equal opportunity, equal facility, equal dignity, isn't it?
Yes, it is, actually. If you talk about Indian basketball, so I will say ki there are 30 teams and or employers who employ male team or male players. So basketball, like 12 players is one team. So it's like almost 360 players, male players are running the show, whereas in women section there's 7 teams or maybe more, like if we pull 8 teams. Total is like number is almost 100 players. So, and recruitment and contract renewal is so less that players cannot bargain for themselves. Even after, you know, 15 years of glittering career of basketball, I cannot bargain for myself as, you know, like as a young basketball male player can do in India. He can ask for, okay, you don't give me pay hike, I will leave the team, I'll go in another team. I'll switch my department. We don't have that luxury. We don't have much employers for us. So that is big problem, and that's why they don't care for us. Until us, we will not have the bargaining capacity. We will not be in, will not be learned, you know, like respected well. Mm-hmm. So that is the big problem in women sports in India, the employment.
So Priya, we saw with USA in 60s, they came up with the Title IX, and something similar was done by UK when they decided to narrow down on certain sports for women. Do you think it's time that India also go the same way, either UK or maybe something like Title IX?
When there's a tried and tested model that has succeeded in UK, in the US, I see absolutely no harm in our country trying to narrow down on sports. I mean, we have the government that is saying they want to spend equally across all sports. Fair enough, they can't show a bias, but somewhere there, a little more support by narrowing down and seeing where and which sport our champions are really emerging from. If we could invest a little bit more there, there probably could be a quicker way to bring some more glory for the country back home. And the other thing is that this, like Anshul mentioned in her own way, that cannot be done singularly. All stakeholders have to take a step forward, be it the government, be it the governing body, the administrators, mm-hmm. corporates, media. Everyone has to come forward to contribute their share for sport to grow and, you know, there come in equality in gender. I mean, I'm trying to make a humble initiative at my end with Badminton Gurukul. Gopi's been rock solid support. Once again, I mention him because it's an initiative with him where we are trying to spread across. The entire initiative has actually started with a woman. Yeah. Aparna Popat, 9-time national champion, looking to switch jobs between Indian Oil, wanting to come back and contribute back to the sport. We say, how do we spread Gopi's learnings across the country? Yeah. And that's when Badminton Gurukul really started. You know, we have about 30 centers now across the country, and half the expert panel, where there's a second wind career for them, are women. We're hiring women coaches at all our centers. So, you know, you need the spread, not just at player level. Yeah. You need it at the administration level. You need representation of women at coach level, technician level, expert level. And that's what we're really trying to do.
Prashanthi, IOC is talking about gender equality. They are going to give 48.8% representation at Tokyo Games. Commonwealth Games Federation saying these are the most gender equal sports because they have kept the equal medal events for women for the first time. In India, are we even thinking about it? Forget about taking the steps?
Not really. See, we can be first one in the whole world, first country to do that. Because, you know, there have been plans, there have been policies to support the women athlete and women, you know, women in India. But, you know, to execute it to the ground level, it is tough. It is tough.
Yeah.
So, what, you know, but, you know, if you want to do something really good, you have to be, like, really tough on the people. Mm-hmm. Tough with the system. You know, like, you, like it cannot be in a requesting manner. It has to be, like, you know, like, forced. It has to be forced. You know, there has to be a seat that it goes to women or it's left.
So thank you very much, you champions, for these great insights. And before I wrap up, I want to tell you, ask all of you, next time when your son or your brother or your friend loses to a woman player, please don't joke. Or please don't tell him, ladki se aar ke aa gaya. Next time he loses, please tell him, you lost to a better player. Thank you very much.